All right, Danny, first time coming to Honduras, prefecture on Tobago, making the long trek over from the UK. Tell us about it and how much are you looking forward to tomorrow night's game?
Yeah, it wasn't the shortest journey, but it's always a blessing to come and play for Trinidad, and it's a blessing to be able to travel to different countries as well to represent your nation. I'm really looking forward to the game tomorrow and eager to get 3 points.
When you look at Honduras, you know what they bring to the game, that physicality, very an explosive sort of game. Central America is going to be a hostile environment. How do you get yourself ready for this sort of challenge?
Yeah, I think we've seen from the clips that they're a very powerful team, dynamic, good on the counter-attack. But we know we have the ability to deal with them. And we're used to playing in hostile environments. We're used to being the underdogs, so it's not something that we're worried about. It's something we thrive on. The environment, the fans being against us.
How have you settled in at your new club? Obviously, leaving Scotland, coming back to England. You also have a teammate who's doing quite well at St Johnstone as well. Tell us about that in terms of, you know, we knew that you put in a good word for Andre at St Johnstone, and now you have an opportunity to make a name for yourself at your new club.
Yeah, so I've settled in really quickly at my new team. For me, it's been a good move. For location-wise, I'm closer to home, closer to my family. But also for the level, I found that my teammates are really good and I've settled in quickly. For Ram, I'm really happy for him. Deserved move. You can see by the fact that he's settled in so quickly and he's doing so well. And it was just a case of I came back from international duty in March, it was, and the manager asked how it was, asked about my teammates, and I said, look, we've got some amazing players you need to have a look at. And thankfully he listened, he looked at Ram and he was eager to bring him in.
Good. Having to come back into the fray, it's not World Cup qualifiers, but Nations League is just as important. It's a qualification for World Cup also. We want to stay up in League 8. How do you switch focus now, knowing that, okay, everybody is talking about World Cup qualifiers, but we also have to bring it when we come to play a Nations League game? How do you manage that?
I think for us as a team, we need every opportunity we can to gel and to perform. So even though it's not a World Cup qualifier, we still prepare just as seriously and we take it as an opportunity to go on the field and build momentum. I think you can see from the last Nations League campaign, the team spirit and the momentum we built helped us to push on to get into the quarterfinals. So we want to do the same thing here, get a good run of games here, October, building for the next set of qualifiers in June.